Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel SRIP Edu Pharma. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the antiarrhythmic drug disopyramide. So let's talk about arrhythmia first of all. What is arrhythmia? Arrhythmia kya hota hai, iske bare mein pehle humko janna padega. Arrhythmia is related with the heart, that is called the cardiac arrhythmia. Cardiac arrhythmias are the abnormalities in the rate regularity or the site of origin of the cardiac impulse, or a disturbance in the conduction of the impulse such that the normal sequence of activation of the atria and the ventricle is altered. Okay, so in this way there is an abnormality in the heart rate. So as we know, the heart rate is 72 beat per minute, as we know. तो अगर उससे कम हार्ट रेट हो जाता है 72 बीट पर मिनट से, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइपोअरिथमिया. एंड इफ इट इज मोर देन 72 बीट पर मिनट, दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइपर अरिथमिया. सो जनरली द ड्रग विच इज टेकन फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द अरिथमिया इज कॉल्ड द एंटी अरिथमिक ड्रग्स. एंड दिस ड्रग इज यूज फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ हाइपर अरिथमिया, मीन्स इफ द हार्ट रेट इज मोर देन 72 बीट पर मिनट फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. तो होता है एग्जैक्टली क्या है कि इफ़ द हार्ट रेट इज मोर देन द कॉन्ट्रेक्शन एंड रिलैक्सेशन प्रेशर इज वेरी हाई ओवर द हार्ट मसल्स, एंड देन द हार्ट मसल्स आर गॉट एपेथिक, थक जाते हैं वो मसल्स, वीक हो जाते हैं, एंड देयर फॉर द हार्ट इज फील्स प्रेशर, एंड ड्यू टू विच देर इज अ स्लोली द हार्ट इज स्टॉप टू गेट वर्क. तो दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम फॉर द चांसेस ऑफ द हार्ट अटैक. तो इसके लिए क्या करना है, हार्ट रेट को फास्ट होने से रोकने के लिए एंटी अरिथमिक ड्रग दिए जाते हैं. इसमें जो ड्रग हैं दे आर कैटेगराइज इनटू द 5 डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज. द क्लास वन ड्रग 4 कैटेगरीज आर देयर. क्लास वन ड्रग, क्लास टू ड्रग्स, क्लास थ्री एंड क्लास फोर ड्रग्स. So in this video actually we have to focus over the chemistry of the disopyramide. So I am just giving the introduction about the what are the different categories and the what are the examples of this those categories of drug. The first class jo class 1 antiarrhythmic drugs mein aate hain, that are the sodium channel blockers we take. And the example of the sodium channel blockers are, तो सोडियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स आर फर्दर कैटेगराइज इन टू द 3 डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर स्ट्रेंथ टू बी ब्लॉक द सोडियम चैनल, लाइक मार्क्ड सोडियम चैनल ब्लॉकर, फिर मॉडरेट टू मार्क्ड, देन माइल्ड टू मॉडरेट. सो कलेक्टिवली वी हैव एग्जाम्पल फ्रॉम दिस कैटेगरी, फ्रॉम सोडियम चैनल ब्लॉकर कैटेगरी इज द क्विनिडीन, प्रोपेनामाइड, डिसोपायरामाइड, ओके, देन वी हैव एनकेनाइड, इंडेकेनाइड एंड सो ऑन. क्लास टू ड्रग्स आर दी बीटा एड्रेनर्जिक ब्लॉकर्स, मीन्स द ड्रग विच ब्लॉक द बीटा रिसेप्टर, एड्रेनर्जिक ब्लॉकर्स, एंड दिस कॉजेज द रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ द मसल्स, कार्डियक मसल्स. बीटा एड्रेनर्जिक ब्लॉकर लाइक ओलोल्स, वी हैव द प्रोप्रानोलॉल, अटेनोलॉल, टीमोलॉल सो ऑन. एंड देन क्लास थ्री इज द कैल्शियम, सॉरी इट इज पोटेशियम चैनल ब्लॉकर. वी टेक द पोटेशियम चैनल ब्लॉकर इन केस ऑफ द अरिथमिया व्हाइल द टेकिंग द पोटेशियम चैनल ओपनर इन केस ऑफ एंजाइना ट्रीटमेंट. सो पोटेशियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स लाइक एमियोडेरॉन एंड ब्रिटालियम. सो दिस आर, ओके, देन लास्ट फोर्थ कैटेगरी इज द कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स. सो वी हैव अ डिटेल क्लासिफिकेशन फॉर कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स, बट इन दिस कैटेगरी वी जस्ट इन ब्रीफ टू फोकस ऑन द केमिस्ट्री मोर. So calcium channel blockers like nifedipines, which is dihydropyridine derivative, nifedipines. We could also have some more drugs from this similar category, like other than nifedipine is the amlodipine and pilodipine and so on. Okay, then verapamil, diltiazem. So these are the few drugs belonging to the different classes, different four classes of the antiarrhythmic drugs. So this is sodium channel blocker, beta adrenergic blocker, potassium channel blocker, and calcium channel blocker. Let's come to the synthesis and chemistry of the disopyramide, which belongs to the sodium channel blocker category. So if you talk about the sodium channel blocker, then we have drug from this category, which is which one? Disopyramide. Okay, so let's talk about the disopyramide. So first of all, let's take the structure. So disopyramide, as the name suggested, diiso, so that is diisopropyl. Pyra means pyridine, amide from acetamide. So these three things are essentially present into the structure. So acetamide is CH3CONH2. So we can take it like CCO and NH2. This can be acetamide if there is a three hydrogens are there. But these three hydrogen from the acetamide has been substituted. So the first hydrogen has been substituted from the CH3 by the phenyl group. Second hydrogen has been substituted with 2-pyridinyl group. This is 2-pyridinyl because this is one and this is second. So the point of attachment is second from the pyridine. And the third hydrogen is replaced from the this group. This is ethyl group, then N, ethylamine, and this N hydrogen from this amine has been substituted from 2-isopropyl group. So this is first isopropyl group, and similarly there is a second isopropyl group is there. We can write it IPR also to this isopropyl. So we have diisopropyl amino ethyl group that is attached with acetamide, and there is a 2-pyridine. So there is diisopropyl, diiso, pyridine is there, pyra, and amide is acetamide is there. So this is the name, this is a structure and the why the name is given for this structure. Then let's take the nomenclature. So if you talk about the nomenclature, we have this acetamide group. This carbon with respect to this CONH2 amide group is alpha carbon. Okay, because first carbon from the functional group is called alpha carbon. So acetamide mein functional group kaun sa hai? CONH2 amide group hai. Iska pehla carbon kya hoga? Alpha. Now this alpha carbon is attached with the different groups. So let's talk about that. First of all, this side, right side, that is the ethyl group. So this is the first carbon, this one is the second carbon. Second carbon se attachment hai amino group ka. And amino group is substituted with diisopropyl. So let's take the nomenclature. First of all, we start with the alpha position. That alpha carbon is there, that is attached with the ethyl group, that is attached with amino group at the second position. So let's take the second of this ethyl. Then we have diisopropyl group, diisopropyl group is there. This diisopropyl group, diisopropyl, that is attached with amine, so we called it amino, diisopropyl amine up to this one. Okay, then it is, this one is ethyl. So this is second position of ethyl, close the square bracket. Okay, so we have this fragment as 2-diisopropyl aminoethyl. Then there is another group is attached from the alpha position again, that is phenyl. So we have alpha phenyl also, and still the alpha position is attached with the 2-pyridinyl. So that is alpha 2-pyridinyl group is there, that is attached with alpha. And this whole means diisopropylamino, phenyl, 2-pyridinyl are attached with the parent molecule that we called as acetamide. So this is acetamide. So we write the acetamide at the end, acetamide. So this is the full nomenclature of the disopyramide structure. Okay, clear? Then start the synthesis. So synthesis can be start from a molecule that is called phenyl acetonitrile. So we have phenyl, this is phenyl acetonitrile, means CH3CN is called acetonitrile, CH3CN, because there is a 2 carbon and 1 carbon belongs to the functional group. We can add the word acid, and CN cyanide is called also called nitrile. So it is acetonitrile, and if this methyl group is substituted with the phenyl, that is called phenyl acetonitrile. So we have phenyl CH2 instead of CH3 and cyanide. So we have, this is called phenyl aceto, this is phenyl, this is aceto, and nitride. So we have nitric acid, nitride. Okay. So this is the precursor for the synthesis. And the second molecule we will take. So first of all, we have to add this pyridine group from here, from its second position. So we will take the second substituted pyridine molecule. So this is our pyridine, and this is first position. This one is second. That is attached with bromine. Then what it will be? It will be 2-bromo, 2-bromo pyridine. So we have 2-bromo pyridine for the reaction with the phenyl acetonitrile. Then from here the bromine and a hydrogen from the active methyl group, that is alpha methyl group. A hydrogen comes from this CH2 group, so N hydrogen, so H and Br. So it will be minus HBr. So it is an acid like HCl, because it is also an halogen. So we need sodamide, which is a base, to remove this HBr like acid. Okay, so what will happen? H yahan se niklega, bromine yahan se niklega. Then we have phenyl from the acetonitrile, this one. Then instead of CH2 it will be CH, because one H has been removed with the HBr, and this point has the deficient with the valency that will going to attach here and this. Okay, then rest is CN, so it is CN. Clear? Then in the next step, what we will do, we will going to attach this whole chain in the form of chloride. So we will, if we take the chloride here, then we can attach this at the site of reaction. So we will take what? We will take Cl, then CH2 and N with diisopropyl group. So this is what it is. This group is diisopropyl amino ethyl chloride, diisopropyl, then amino, then ethyl, and this is chloride that we will take. Okay, then what will happen? This chlorine and this hydrogen will remove as minus HCl, and we again need, like HBr we have HCl, so we need the same base like sodamide here. Okay, so in this case what will happen? There is a HCl will going to remove, and this whole fragment will going to attach instead of this H. Then the next structure we will have like this phenyl molecule as such. Okay, then C, this is attached with 2-pyridinyl group, so we have 2-pyridinyl. And then instead of writing it the horizontally, we will take it the cyanide vertically. H has been removed as HCl and chlorine has been removed, then this group will going to attach CH2. Then N, here we will attach the isopropyl group, this one isopropyl group, and here we also have the isopropyl group. Clear? Then in the last step, what we will do, we just need to convert this cyanide to amide, CONH2. So we need to just hydrolyze this molecule in the presence of dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4. This will help to convert this cyanide to the amide. So in the same sequence, this is phenyl molecule from here. Then we have carbon, this 2-pyridinyl group. Okay, then we have CH2, twice likh dete hain isko, CH2 ko, and it is attached with N, that has already attached with isopropyl, this CONH2. So we have H2O, O here and H2 here, so it will become CONH2. So it is CO and H2 in the presence of water coming from this dilute H2SO4. So it is disopyramide. So we have this structure. Okay, now let's talk about the mechanism of action. So if we talk about the mechanism of action, disopyramide is simply a sodium channel blocker, and disopyramide is also have the membrane stabilizing activity, and their characteristic effect on the action potential is a reduction in the rate of depolarization during the depolarization phase, like that is called phase zero, and thus block the high frequency excitation of the myocardium that occurs in dysrhythmia. So simply it is actually avoid the depolarization by blocking the sodium channel and thus providing the membrane stabilizing activity of the cardiac muscle cells. So in this way we can avoid the increased heart rate by relaxing the cardiac muscles. Okay, so this is all about the disopyramide and chemistry of the antiarrhythmic drug. So if you like this video, please like, subscribe, and for more update press the bell icon. Till then, thank you.